Hare Krishna. Don't just keep waiting, keep pushing too. Sometimes, some people, when they are encouraged to explore life's spiritual dimension, to take to spiritual life, they say, oh, you know, when the right time comes, I will do it. When God calls me from within the heart, when I feel that calling, then I will do it. While this might seem to be like a reasonable proposition, still we have to think that how do we work in life? Do we keep waiting for things that are important for us? We don't just keep waiting, we also keep pushing. Suppose somebody wants to get a degree in their lives. Now, that degree, they may be students right now and the degree may be 10 years down the line. But they're pushing. Every day they are going to college or school, studying, preparing for the exams. So they're not just passively waiting for one day somebody will come and bestow the degree on them. They're also pushing themselves to do what it takes to get the degree. Another example could be, say, if a woman is pregnant and is on the verge of delivery. Now, yes, the baby will be delivered at a particular time. But at the same time, as the time nears, the mother also has to work and the mother has to push. You know, so she can't just keep waiting, she also has to keep pushing. And it's only by the combination of pushing and waiting is not passive waiting, it's working. So then at the right time, the baby will be delivered. So in our own spiritual life, we could say that the same combination of waiting and pushing is required. We cannot advance, grow spiritually faster than what is ordained by providence. We cannot gate crash into the kingdom of God. That means there is a pace at which we'll grow, just as a baby cannot grow into an adult in 6 months. Similarly, we cannot rise from our present level of conditioning to very high level of purity overnight. It is going to take time. So in that sense, even if we want for high levels of purity, we want deep absorption in Krishna, all this is going to take time. So we need to be patient and we need to keep waiting. But this waiting is not passive. We have to keep pushing. To keep pushing ourselves to take small steps towards Krishna. To do what we can in His service. Unless we do our part, we will not grow. The Bhagavad Gita talks about this reciprocity when it says that, for example, 8.7, Tasmat Sarveshu Kaleshu Ma Manusmara Yodhyacha That therefore, always think of me and do your external duty, which for Arjuna was fighting. And this way, with your mind and intelligence absorbed in me, you will come to me. Of this, have no doubt. And the same dialectic we find, these two aspects, that keep pushing and keep waiting. So Krishna tells in 9.34 in the Bhagavad Gita that always think of me and if you do this, you will come to me. Madmanabhav madbhakto madhyaji mam namaskuru mame vaishyasi yuktvaivam atmanam matparayanaha. With your being devoted to me, you will surely come to me. And in 18.65 he says, Madmanabhav madbhakto madhyaji mam namaskuru mame vaishyasi satyam te pratijane priyosime. He says, if you do this, surely you will come to me. I guarantee it because I speak the truth because you are very dear to me. I speak it for your benefit. So, when we are waiting, actually God is acting. But when we are pushing, we are acting. And both parts are required for our spiritual growth. When we recognize that spiritual life is a growth is a symbiotic effort, we won't be disheartened if we are not growing as fast as we want, as we anticipated or hoped. But at the same time, we won't become lethargic and leave everything to Krishna. We will do our part and we will wait and watch as Krishna does his part. And in this, by this synergy, we will advance towards pure love and the eternal happiness thereof. Thank you. Hare Krishna.